Hello?
Are we on?
We're on. We're here. Hello?
Hi.
Are you guys here with us? It is Sunday morning. Brian has a broomstick. I don't know why that's funnier than it probably should be. But we are here this morning. We've got Ryan. We've got Miss Karina coming in the house today. We've got about 25-minute rep portion, and then we've got a 20 to 25-minute yoga flow coming at you today, led by Karina. Right now, she's my partner in crime, but over there, she's going to be leading this rodeo. That's what we're going to call it today. So a couple of things that you're going to need for today's workout. If you guys don't have a kettlebell, we've got our handy-dandy milk jug full of water, if you'd like. Without water, if you don't, I'm not really sure. Hang on, let me turn this down just a little bit. My power song coming on this morning. All right. So the other thing that we are going to use today, if you want to get it now, is going to be this handy-dandy other weight. This is a suitcase. It's a carry-on size. We are going to use this for some weights work today as well. We also have a couple of other options just for you guys that are at home that don't have any dumbbells, don't have any kettlebells. They're just kind of make and do. I'm pretty creative. I've done a lot of workouts out on the go without a gym, so I use what I have available. Ryan has a broomstick around here somewhere. We'll go over that in just a second, but you can take that broomstick. Actually, we're going to go over it right now because we have time. I'm in. This right here is a broomstick. If you do not have one of these, I don't know how you're living life. So you should have one of these. If you want to take it just like this, you can. If you want to add some weight to it, you're going to take a backpack. We should all have one of those, a bag of any kind, really. You can take a Publix bag, fill it with oranges or soap or rocks from your yard, whatever. And that's going to decide your weight for things that we're going to do with this today. So we've got a couple of things that we're doing today that you could use the broomstick with the backpack. You could use the carry-on luggage, and the milk jug is also going to be needed as well. Thanks, handy dandy assistant Ryan. All right, guys, are we ready to get going here?
Yay!
I mean, I was mediocre at best, but it's fine. There's only two of them.
Let's do it.
So. All right, so today's workout is going to be Tabata 30-15. 30 seconds of work, 15 seconds of rest. Math was really hard this morning, I'm not going to lie. But we have the rounds figured out. I have relied on Ryan to make sure that that is set properly. It is going to be four rounds of each exercise. We're going to alternate them, and then we're going to take a minute break. So our first movement is going to be a kettlebell figure eight. You're going to grab either your kettlebell or your milk jug. You're going to drop down into that squat position. You're going to weave that kettlebell or that milk jug in between those legs, holding that squat, keeping that chest up and proud. Knees are about shoulder width apart, slight bend outwards. Keep that core engaged the entire time. You have 30 seconds there. Our second movement, we have two options for. It's gonna be our tuck jump, where you're gonna get those hands up, tuck up in, into that jump. Or if that's not working for you, the jump isn't happening, you're gonna do a half burpee, drop it back, hop it back. You don't have to stand it all the way up, but hop it back like this for the entire 30 seconds. And if you're not hopping, you're stepping. I don't remember who my modifier is in the back. Ryan, oh wait, they're both waiting, just so you guys know. It's a little bit weird. I don't know what's happening right now. All right, guys.
Okay.
Oh, you were pointing. Okay, Karina is gonna be our standard girl, lifting the heavy things. Ryan's gonna be our modifier, lifting the also heavy things that are non-conventional. All right, guys, I'm gonna give you like 20 seconds to grab your items, get prepared. We're gonna fire up some tunes. We're gonna start this Sunday off right. Whew, it's hot in here today. We've got hot rep going on today. We don't believe in air conditioning on Sundays. Not really sure if that's a thing, but it is today. I mean, I feel it, you feel it, we're already sweaty. It's hot. All right, guys, are we ready? All right, here we go. We are gonna fire that up. I'm gonna run over here, I'm gonna get it started. 30 seconds on that clock with those kettlebell finger eights coming at you. 3, 2, 1. That's okay. It's okay. It's fine. It's fine, guys. It's fine.
Everything's fine.
There you go. How about that? little bit of music for my team. We are halfway through, guys. Ryan's throwing his jugs around. Right into those tuck jumps. Get ready. If you're not doing the tuck jumps, you are doing those half burpees. I'm gonna give us just a little bit better view of Karina. There we go. Butter hands Ryan. That is a great nickname. We are on that clock for those tuck jumps. Karina is hitting those jumps. Ryan's hitting those half burpees. Again, on those half burpees, you don't have to stand all the way up. If you're not jumping, you're stepping it in and out. Be mindful of that jump. Keep breathing all the way through. Take a breath as you need to. Karina is crushing it. I think Ryan decided not to do the jumps because he didn't want to mess up his hair, which is fine. I get it. I'm just staying away. 2-1. Rest it out, guys. We're going to come right back into those kettlebell figure eights in 15 seconds. Get your jug, your kettlebell, whatever. We got 5 seconds. Catch your breath. 2-1. Weaving it in and out, keeping that booty low, weight in those heels. You are able to, Ryan's still throwing things around back there. Don't know what's happening. He's definitely not gonna be a receiver on any football team today. Maybe the Bucks. Ha ha, just kidding. All right guys, 10 seconds here, hold on to it. Coming into those half burpees or tuck jumps. 3, 2, 1, just kidding, we get 15 seconds of rest. Whew. We're gonna wait, we're gonna hang out, we're gonna get ready. We're gonna be ready to tuck jump. No, you're doing it fine.
Sorry.
5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. As you come into that half burpee hop step forward, make sure that you're landing with those heels, that full chunk of the foot on the ground. That way you're not putting all that weight on those toes. We're halfway through, guys. Karina's over here. She's feeling those jumps right now. I can feel the energy coming off of her. We are resting in 3, 2, 1. Go ahead and rest it up. Get that jug ready. We're gonna come back into those kettlebell figure eight. And I'm gonna give us just a little bit of AC. Not a lot, just a little bit. 3, 2, 1. Right back into those figure eights. If we're not using a weight, if we don't have a jug, if we don't have anything to put in our hands, we can just hold that squat.
It's working, so that's right. That will work.
There you go. Nice job. Keep that head, chest up and proud. Nice job. Nice job. Looking good, Karina. Karina's watching that clock like a hawk. Brian is keeping a hold of his jumps for the first round ever. Rest it out, 15 seconds. Run right back into those tuck jumps and that half burpee. Whichever one you're doing, whatever's working for you today. All right, guys. 3, 2, 1. Coming into that half burpee. Karina, killing those tuck jumps. Look at how those knees drive up into that chest. Hands are up overhead as she comes up. She's almost jumping rope really aggressively without a jump rope. Nice job. Nice job. All right, guys, hold on to it. We have got 5 seconds left. Try and get 3 more in. We are resting in 3, 2, 1. Rest it out. Rest it out. Our final round of kettlebell figure eights coming at you right now. This is where the math part really got me this morning. I don't know why, but thank God Ryan was here. 2, 1, here we go. Final round of these guys. I'm gonna participate in this one. Keeping it low. We should have made this a drinking game. Guys, come back and watch this later. And then every time Ryan drops a weight, take a shot. I mean, we're on quarantine. Let's have a good time with this.
We're only on round one.
We're only on round one. That is accurate. There's so much time for him to drop more things. 3, 2, 1. Rest it out, guys. Final round of these tuck jumps, half burpees, whichever one you're doing today. Then we get a full minute of rest to go over the next 2 movements. Are we ready?
Yes.
All right. Let's go! On that clock, guys. Half burpees. Tuck jumps. Karina is getting her workout in today. I feel like the screen keeps moving. I don't know if it's the power of Karina's jump that's making that happen, or what, or maybe Ryan throwing weights around, moving the space. I'm not really sure, but either way, we are making some things happen. Come on, Karina, two more. Two, one, rest. All right, guys, we have a full minute of rest. Grab a drink, whatever you need, grab your suitcase. This next set of exercises, we are gonna be on the ground floor. We are gonna take that suitcase, bring it up over our head. We're gonna bring those glutes up, and we've got a chest press here. Focus on keeping that suitcase, that weight over that chest, really squeezing those pecs as we come up. Keep that glute, those glutes engaged up in the air the entire 30 seconds. If that gets to be too much, you can drop that down and go to a standard chest press, depending on what kind of weight you have in your suitcase. We also have skull crushers, so that movement, again, still staying on the ground. You're gonna take that suitcase, keep those elbows at that 90 degree bend, bring that suitcase down to that forehead. Squeeze those triceps at the top. If you wanna take the glutes up for this one too, add that extra challenge, you certainly can. All right, guys, are we ready to get this thing started? Woo! You have your suitcase?
I rolled it away.
Be mindful of your suitcase having wheels. Karina's got her mat. She's got her weights. She's getting ready to get this going. We're all friends here. We don't share well. All right, guys. I'm going to get us fired up. Get ready. 30 seconds on that clock for those glute bridge chest presses. 3, 2, 1. Nice job, nice job. You see a nice line on both of our models today. Karina's got those glutes engaged all the way up, keeping those dumbbells in line with that chest. Thinking about those pecs, really engaging that muscle group. Ryan is doing the same over here. Nice straight line, glutes are engaged, hips are up. You guys have 3, 2, 1. Go ahead and rest for 15. Then we're gonna come right back, or we're gonna come into those skull crushers. That's gonna be elbows directly in front of you, just bending there, 90 degree. We have 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1.
I don't know how to see you guys, but hopefully you can see us all. Oh, yep, you can. There we go, perfect.
All right, guys, we are halfway through this first round of these skull crushers. You should start to feel it in that tricep if you're not already. Nice squeeze at the top. 3, 2, 1, go ahead and rest. Again, that modification like Karina was doing is keep that glute raised in effect through that entire skull crusher. Ryan's our modifier, he's got our suitcase, he's got his booty on the ground. We're coming at it, 2, 1, those chest presses, guys. Drive through those heels to keep those glutes engaged. Squeeze the glutes, making sure that they're engaged the entire time, and keep breathing. Be mindful of keeping that, those dumbbells, that suitcase, whatever you're using as a weight, right in line with that chest. You have 10 seconds left here, guys. Nice shot. I don't know what we're listening to. 3, 2, 1. Go ahead. I know. It is weird. We've got air conditioning now. We're starting to feel a little more alive, a little less fatigued. Coming right back in 2, 1. We've got those skull crushers coming at you. If you guys can see Miss Karina here, she is keeping those glutes engaged. She is keeping those elbows right here at the top, only moving those as she bends up and down. Yes. Really keeping that body engaged. That core is nice and tight. Only moving at those elbows. We've got 5 seconds left here. Ryan's nice and focused. I wish you guys could see his face. 2, 1, rest. All right, guys, we are halfway through this full round. Two down, two to go. Whew, we're feeling good. We're feeling good, right?
Yeah.
Two, one. Come into those chest presses. Keeping those elbows nice and lined. Nice straight line. Keeping that core engaged. Raise those glutes up. I knew it was coming. Serena, spin. Right on track right there. Knees in line with those heels. Pushing through. Nice squeeze the entire time. You guys are looking solid. Three, two, one. Rest. Right back to those skull crushers, guys. Three, two, one. Skull crushers. Keep those elbows tucked in. Nice and straight line. There you go. Only that elbow is moving. We're going to adjust this for one more time. There you go. Squeeze that tricep up at the top of that. Nice job. Glutes are engaged. Glutes are going to be on fire about now. We are counting it down. Three, two, one. Nice job. Take that rest. It is well earned. Catch your breath. Gather your thoughts. Think about what brought you in here today. Think about why you're watching this today and how you're gonna make changes in this time off that we have. Three, two, one. Right back to it, guys. Chest press, final round of these chest presses. Make it count. Give it a nice squeeze at the top. Focus on that mind-muscle connection, driving through those pecs as you push forward on those weights. Nice job. Core's engaged, glutes are tight. Building that booty while we work that chest. Keep breathing, guys. Nice exhale as you push up. Two, one, rest. Final round of skull crushers, then we get a full minute of rest here. If you haven't been doing the glute bridge with the skull crushers, try and give it a shot this time. Push your body to that next level. Raise those glutes up, give them a nice squeeze. Two, one. Let's go, guys. Final round of skull crushers. Move a little bit faster, squeeze a little bit tighter, push just a little bit harder. We have that full minute of rest coming at us as soon as we're done. There you go. Looking good here, Ryan. Looking solid, Karina. 10 seconds left, and we get a full minute of rest. Guys, work hard here. Push through. Make it happen. Three, two, one. Go ahead and rest. Our next set of movements, you're going to need your broomstick in your backpack. We've got a bent over row and a front raise. So you're going to bend over and hinge at those hips. Get those arms nice and straight in front of you using this broomstick. Bend all the way over, nice flat back. Drive that broomstick up into that chest, engaging those lats, bringing it right up to that belly button level. You guys can add weight to this. You can decrease weight on that and just use a broomstick. You can also use your double jugs and just keep that nice and low. Hey, watch yourself, friends. All right, guys. Then our next set of movements, right back into that broomstick. It's gonna be a front raise. With or without the weight on it, we're gonna bring those up, those arms up to that 90 degree angle, right at that shoulder height, working those delts, those shoulders. 30 seconds of each. Get ready, guys. I don't feel like Ryan and Karina, either one of them are ready, but I'm ready. You guys are almost ready. Here we go, 30 seconds on that clock. Are we ready?
Yes.
Ready. We have 3 seconds left, then we're moving into those front races. Three, two, one. This could be less. We're not there. We're not
in front. Did you say front races? Oh, yeah, I forgot.
so excited.
You are so excited. All right, here we go, guys. Right into those front raises. However you are doing them, be mindful of your neighbor. If you're using that broomstick, stop on the gaze until Karina loses her face. Nice squeeze up at the top. Make sure that you are controlling the movement down and it's not just gravity driving you down. You guys should know that my backpack is actually pretty heavy. So, you can adjust the weight of your backpack. Rest it out, guys. We're at that 30-second mark. Coming right back into those bent over rows. You need to adjust that weight, add some things to the back, take some things out of the back. You can also use a suitcase for this bent over row, keeping it nice and tight, tucked in if that works better. We're back on that clock, guys. Good to work. I'm just gonna show you guys what this looks like with that suitcase. Squeeze those lats up at the top. Nice slow tempo on the way down. We have 5 seconds left. Hold on to it. Trying to get three more. Rest. 15 seconds of rest. Going into those front raises. Brian's going to his jugs for those front raises. 2, 1. Nice and straight. Squeeze those shoulders up at the top. Again, make sure that it is you controlling that movement down and it's not gravity pushing them through. You're bringing them up, controlling them down. Halfway through. Looking good there, Karina. Nice straight lines from both of our models here today. Started to call them models now. Nice job. Nice engagement of these shoulders. 2, 1. Rest it out. Get ready to come right back into those rows, please.
I'm gonna, yeah.
You want to get a short backpack if you don't have cargo between you and the ground. All right, guys, right back to it. Right into those rows. Nice and engaged. Nice bent all the way over. Brian's got a nice flat back. He's keeping those lats engaged, nice squeeze at the top. Karina is doing the same over here. I'm gonna back her up just a little bit. She is out of frame. There you go. So that way you can see she's got a nice line, nice squeeze up at the top. We are resting in 2, 1. All right, guys. Coming into those front raises in 5. I forget you guys can see the timer, so yep. When I say things like that, it's really a lie. 2, 1, right into those front raises. Squeeze those shoulders up at the top, coming right to that 90 degree shoulder mark, not going past that. Squeeze as you come up, slow and controlled on that way down. Nice breaths all the way through. Halfway through, guys. Looking good, looking good. Nice control of movements as we calm down. 3, 2, 1. Go ahead and rest. Get ready for our final, is it our final round?
Yes.
Final round of these bent over rows. Like I said, I don't know why math is so hard for me today, but it is. All right. 2, 1. There you go. Drive through those heels, rolling those weights up into that belly button. Nice tight core. Should feel that in your hamstrings, in your lats, all through those biceps as well as you squeeze up at the top. We have 10 seconds left here, guys. This is our last round. Try to get 4 or 5 more reps in. Squeeze all the way up. Muscle under tension. 2, 1. Rest it out. Coming into that final round of those front raises. Squeeze up at the top. Slow and controlled on the way down. We have 5 seconds left. I actually looked this time. 2, 1. All the way up. Slow and controlled on that way down. Nice straight line as we come up. Working those jugs, working those dumbbells, working that broomstick, whatever we've got today, guys. Halfway through, make it count, keep moving. We don't stop until that timer, guys. We got a full minute of rest after this, then we're gonna move into some core and booty work. 3, 2, 1. Nice job, guys. Go ahead, grab a drink, grab a mat or a towel if you have one, so we can go ahead and get started on the second set. First movement is gonna be a hip dip. You're gonna drop down into that plank position, elbow plank, dropping those hips side to side. Let those heels follow or lead those hips as you drop. You've got 30 seconds of those. And we're coming into donkey kicks. You're gonna be in that tabletop position. Drive that knee straight up into the air. Forward, back, squeeze those glutes at the top. If you guys wanna add a little bit to that, you can put a weight or a water bottle in that bend of that knee for those donkey kicks. All right. They're still grabbing drinks. They're still getting mats. I don't know what they're doing over here.
They're thirsty, Tiffany.
All right, guys. I'm gonna make my sprint. Dropping down to those elbows for these donkey kicks. does this, you still want to make sure that you are keeping that leg at that 90 degree, engaging that glute. Squeeze those glutes. Don't let the legs fall backwards, bending out more and reaching. They want to stay at that 90 degree. Drive that heel towards the hip. 2, 1. Rest it out, guys. This is our final minute of work, 30 seconds at a time. 30 seconds of hip dips coming at you. 30 seconds of donkey kicks. Then we're taking it straight over to yoga to finish off this workout this morning. Let's go. Hip dips. Nice job. Keep it controlled, but maybe speed it up a notch. Maybe take it to that next level. Push a little bit harder. Get that heart rate up a little bit more. Looking for this Sunday.
There you go. I got you.
There you go. There you go. These kids are busting through this. I'm not keeping track, but it's pretty quick. Nice work. Hold on to it. You guys at home. 3, 2, 1. Rest. All right. Final round of donkey kicks, guys. Really squeeze that glute. Really drive that knee down. Hold on to it. Keep that core engaged. Every part of your body is engaged on this final round of work. 2, 1. Karina's come back up to that full tabletop position, driving through. Nice 90 degree bend. You can see those legs doing a lot of the work. You can see the glutes doing a lot of the work. You guys are crushing it right now, building that booty. You guys at home, I know it hurts. I know you're tired. Stick with it. We are almost there. 10 seconds left on that clock. Think about what brought you to us today and what you want to do with the rest of your day. 3, 2, 1. Nice job, nice job. Grab a drink, towel off. We're heading over to yoga. It's gonna take us just a second to make an adjustment and we will be right with you.
I don't know what you guys can see over there. We're just gonna adjust just a little bit here. All right, there we go, perfect.
All right, guys, Karina is gonna lead yoga. Kick off those shoes, socks are optional.
Nice big breaths in. Exhale down and back.
When and if you're ready.
When and if you're ready. Spread your palms nice and wide. Reach your fingertips right down to the floor.
Yeah.
moment, walk those hands over to the left side of your mat. Shifting the body weight over to the left. Push the right hand. So someone's looking at you from above. You're trying to make almost a little C curve in the side of your spine, creating some space and some openness in the right side and the back of the ribs. When you're ready, bring those hands back to center. Take a nice deep breath.
Remember, if you do this workout, shoot us a tag, a like, a post. Let us know that you did it. This light is so bright right here. Normally my face isn't that bad. But tag us in a post. We got some cool stuff coming at you as soon as we open back up again. That's not creepy at all. All right, bye guys. Have a great Sunday.